Most people in the rural areas of Tanzania cook on open fire, provided either by three stone fires on the ground or conventional cookstoves. To fuel them, they use charcoal or firewood, which they collect from the surrounding forests. Over decades, this extensive need for firewood has caused deforestation, leading to soil erosion, disruption of the water cycle, and thereby ultimately to food insecurity. When local initiatives started addressing this problem in the early 1990s, they saw two solutions: planting new trees and somehow reducing the amount of firewood needed. Chema is such a community organization in the northwestern Karagwe district. Apart from efforts in reforestation, they also specialize in producing improved cookstoves.
When we were planting trees, we assumed that after a year there were many forests of trees. Unfortunately, when we turned back, we found no trees. And when we asked where were the trees we planted, they said that because of the scarcity of firewood, we aim to cut them for cooking. Then the idea of improved cookstove, which uses fuel, started from there.
The so-called rocket stove is designed such that the amount of firewood needed for cooking is reduced by half. Thus, deforestation, with its long-term consequences, is encountered. And through more efficient combustion of the gases, this technology also minimizes the emission of particulate matter and greenhouse gases. But beyond the ecological impact, this low-cost technology also contributes to the overall development of the communities.
When we go to the community, we ask them, what's really burdening your family? They will mention collection of firewood. And this is the main task for women and children, especially girls.
The increased scarcity of wood means that women and girls have to spend more time to walk further and further distances. Time that keeps them from learning or pursuing other tasks, and also exposes them to the dangers of assault or rape on their ways.
We had a research for 15 villages, and the conclusion comes that women, they are working for 16 hours a day. Men, 7 hours. If you consider they are collecting firewood, they are collecting water daily, and then they have to attend the school matters. So you may see how time left is studying.
All over Tanzania, small-scale businesses like Chema produce such adapted cookstoves.
You use less fuel. As you use less fuel, you gain time for working on income-generating activities, and there are no emissions, no smoke. You reduce risks. All those are advantages using this improved cookstove.
Later, they had the idea to try to completely remove firewood by using other biofuels. Combining academic research and international open license designs of so-called microgasifiers, Chema started adapting this technology to the local resources.
We found that our community are growing coffee, maize, beans, are growing groundnuts and others. All those, the leftover of those cereal crops and other crops, can be used as biomass.
But whilst the rocket stove has proven its efficiency, with the microgas technology, a number of challenges remain. Apart from the technical difficulties of adapting the stove design to different organic matter, the technology also needs to gain social acceptance.
You can have all these cooking systems. You have four type of stoves here, all relying from the bioenergy. Unless there is a scarcity, normally the cooks have their priority on selecting what stove to use.
And of course, affordability is a decisive factor for successful implementation. The price for a manufactured stove lies around $23, an amount that many rural families cannot afford. Currently, Chema delivers prototypes of microgasifiers to a number of households to monitor their efficiency under real-life conditions.
There's some kind of a stove test called kitchen performance test, where you are trying to calculate how much fuel wood is used to cook 1 kilogram of food. And then you work backward from material flow, fuel wood used.
With the results of these field trials and more research in the workshops, microgasifiers could become a sustainable and eco-friendly alternative to open fire in Tanzania.